Welcome back, guys. In the interest of time, I have developed a code for this solution in UiPath Studio to demonstrate how a working solution looks like. I'll run it for you and will try to explain how it's working. And don't get too worried about the coding part. In the next few videos, I'll also develop it for you to give you a feel that how easy it is to develop it with almost no coding knowledge and just based on basic programming concepts. So when we look at the program, it looks more like a flowchart, which has few steps sequentially. Do these steps look familiar? Yes, these are the exact same steps which we saw in our 2B process. Let's see what this program is trying to do. It's opening a browser, entering the URL, then read the input Excel, builds an output data variable, enters and extract the input and output data for each row in the Excel, and finally it writes output in the Excel file. And this is the Excel we are using for our input and output. And this is the input sheet. It has four columns: type of loans, loan amount, interest rate and tenure. The first column states type of loans, home loan, car loan, personal loan, what kind of loan it is, and other three columns are the input values for the three text boxes. Same Excel, we have the output sheet wherein we have the output variables loan EMI, total interest and total amount, wherein we will have the output for each row corresponding to the input Excel. Alright, let's try running it. Please watch carefully how the program mimics the human interaction with the website. I am starting the run now. It will open the IE browser, enter the URL. If you remember, the first was the home loan, first input. So it's clicking on home loan, entering all the input values from the first row, and simultaneously also noting down the output values. Second was car loan, noting down the output values. All these output values are being stored in a data table variable, which in turn would be written into the output Excel. Let's have a look at the output. Alright, we have got our output values. So this is how this program runs. We'll get into each module's detail in our next videos.